After the burial, after the luncheon at the Knights of Columbus, after the goodbyes, Dave drove Donlin out to the graveyard. Their people were buried here, now including the youngster they both thought of as son. Sometime during the luncheon, a giant wreath had been brought and set at the boy's grave. Now Dave, without warning, became more violent than Donlin had ever seen him. He tore the wreath apart with his hands, and then picked up what remained and hurled it down the hill. "The mayor's office," he said. "He's blocked every move we've made to clean up the toxic waste sites in town. He's on their payroll. But he always makes sure to send a wreath when one of us dies from all the poisons in the water and the ground." He choked on his tears. "I told you. That's what happened to Sam. Pancreatic cancer. 7 kids died of pancreatic cancer here in the last year. The statistics show that that's just about impossible unless pollution is a huge factor. The old doc, Cooney, he's the only one who'll stand up and tell the truth. The other two, the young ones, they're all buddy-buddy with the men who own the factory." He then took Donlin around and showed him the gravestones of all those suspected of dying of pollution-caused cancer in the past 10 years. The stones had small circles of green spray-painted on them. 39 gravestones in all, the oldest victim being 18. "And there'll be a lot more. You can bet on that." They started down the hill to the car. "It ever bother you?"
"Does what ever bother me?"
Donla knew what Dave was asking. He just wanted to make his younger brother say it out loud. "Killing people?"
"Not the people I kill. I'm doing society a favor."
"You ever sorry about the bargain you made?"
"Sometimes."
The bargain had been simple enough. Donlin's mother had found his suitcase open one morning. He kept newspaper clippings of every hit. Vanity. She asked him about them. Dave came in, and when he heard what his mother was saying, he started asking Donlin too. The whole family had been suspicious of how he'd supported himself since coming back from the war. Janice had overheard a couple of strange phone calls. When Dave told her about the newspaper clippings, she realized how he was making his money. They gave him a choice: quit taking assignments or leave town immediately, even though Janice was 3 months pregnant. He'd tried it for a month, but it didn't work for him. He took a job and did it fast, but they still suspected and called him on it. He left town. Dave drove Donlin back to his car.
"You stopping by the house?"
"Guess not."
"You're just leaving, huh?"
"Pretty much." They sat in the front seat, in back of the Knights of Columbus, where Donlin had left his rental.
"I'd appreciate it if you wouldn't come back. Nothing to worry about there. She told me last night that she still loved you."
"She loves you, too."
"Yeah, but not in the way I want."
"I'm sorry, Dave."
Dave put his head down and then raised it.
"You would have liked him. He was a great kid."
"That's what Janice said."
"And nobody's going to pay for it. For him dying, I mean."
Donlin pushed his hand out. They shook.
"So long."
"Yeah, Sully.
So long."
They were out on the water and had been all morning. The sun was hot and merry. Donlin wore his dopey fishing hat. Kay was stretched out on the hammock he'd strung. He didn't give a damn about news, but she did. She was giving her laptop a workout, reading all the papers online.
"Wow," she said. "Listen to this. Donlin was fishing off the side.
Do I have to?
You left your old hometown too early.
Yeah, how's that?
You were telling me about all the pollution there? Well, the guy who runs that paint plant? Somebody grabbed him when he was coming out of work two nights ago and stabbed him with a syringe. Gave him some kind of injection.
The fish can hear you talking. That's why they're not biting.
They did tests, and they found that what he got injected with was some of the spill from one of his toxic waste dumps.
She read a bit more of the story.
He's really sick, but it could take him quite a while to actually die.
Yeah, Donlin said. Too bad he has to suffer like that.
A few minutes later, he got his first bite for the day, and it was a damned good one.